Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing one example on Laurent'z and Taylor series. So this is our given problem, Laurent'z and Taylor series. So this is our first problem actually. So the given problem is all the possible Laurent'z and Taylor's series expansion for the given function about z is equal to 0 or origin. So friends, before going ahead, let me give you two formulas that will be required in this particular question. One is, these are the basic formulas not related to this particular chapter. 1 minus x inverse. So both are minus, so everything will be plus. So 1 plus x square plus x cube plus dot dot dot. And the second one is 1 plus x inverse. So see here, this is positive sign, this is negative sign. So therefore, we'll be considering alternate plus minus sign. So 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus dot dot dot. So these are the basic formulas that we'll be requiring in this particular question. So let's move on. So before going ahead, before starting with the topic, first of all, you need to find it out partial fraction. So let 1 upon z, so this is my given problem, z plus 1, z minus 2, so this is the given problem. And as we are aware about partial fraction, all the three roots are linear roots, so there will be separated by a upon z, b upon z plus 1, and c upon z minus 2. So let us start solving the partial fraction part for this particular problem. So 1 upon z, z plus 1, z minus 2 equal to, here also the LCM is said z, z plus 1 and z minus 2. In the numerator, a will be multiplied to these two factors. So that is z plus 1, z minus 2 plus b multiplied to z, z minus 2 plus c multiplied to z and z plus 1. Now friends, my main aim is to get the value of a, b and c. So getting the values, we have two methods. So I'm explaining one method in this example. You can go ahead with the second method also. So there will be substitutions. Since we need to find three values a, b, c, so there will be three substitutions. So the substitution depends upon the given problem. In the problem, the first factor is z. So therefore, we'll take z equal to 0. The next one is z plus 1. Therefore, we'll take z plus 1 equal to 0. And the last factor is z minus 2. So therefore, we'll take z minus 2 is equal to 0. This is very simple technique. Whatever given in the problem, you just equate it to 0. In the problem, z plus 1 is a factor given in the problem, so z plus 1 equal to 0. The second factor is z minus 2 given in the problem, z minus 2 equal to 0. And the last one is z equal to 0. So if I'll substitute z is equal to 0, z equal to minus 1 and z equal to 2 in the above equation. So let us see what I'm getting. So let us put these values in the above equation to get the value of a, b, c. So z equal to 0. So if you put z is equal to 0, left side is 1 equal to, see there are three terms in the numerator, a z plus 1, z minus 2, b z, z minus 2, c z, z plus 1. So if you put z equal to 0, b is multiplied to z. That means I'm talking about this term. So that term will become 0. And if you put z equal to 0 in the last term, this term, that will also become 0. So these two terms will become 0 if you put z equal to 0. And you will be left with only a term. So if you put here z equal to 0 in this particular term, so a 1 and minus 2. That means the value of a is equal to minus half. So this is the first value that we got. So let us now put z is equal to minus 1 in the above equation. So left side is 1 equal to, z is equal to minus 1. If you put in this factor, so minus 1 plus 1 will become 0. this one, I'm talking about this one. Minus 1 plus 1, 0. So 0 into anything is 0. The entire term will become 0. So this term will be gone. If you put z is equal to minus 1 in the last term, again, here, minus 1 plus 1, 0. So 0 into anything is 0. The entire term will become 0. You will be left with b only. So in b, if you put z is equal to minus 1, you will be getting minus 1. Minus 1 minus 2, that is minus 3. So in short, b equal to 1 by 3. Now let us discuss for the last value, z is equal to 2. So if you put z is equal to 2 in the above equation, left side is same, 1 equal to z equal to 2. See here, this a, if you put 2 here, 2 minus 2, 0. 0 into anything is 0. So entire term will be gone. Next, if you put in B's term, again 2 minus 2 is 0, the entire term is again 0, you will be left with only one term, C, right? Yes. So let us put in C term, so C, 2, 3. So the value of C is 1 by 6. So friends, now we got the value of ABC. So let us put the values of ABC in this particular equation. So therefore, f of z equal to, see here, this is a, right? So we got the value of a as minus half. So this is minus 1 by 2z plus b. This b is 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 z plus 1 plus c, 1 by 6. So 1 by 6 z minus 2. So what is the advantage of partial fraction? See friends, my question is to expand and these three factors are in multiplication, right? So my main aim is to separate these factors with plus or minus. So I want to separate it out into the different factors. So therefore, I'm using partial fraction. So I did it. Let's move on to the main part of the problem. Now let us actually starting with the problem. And we need to find it out. First of all, region of convergence, that is your ROC. Region of convergence. So let us see what is given. The first is z. Z means we always take mod. That's it. We always take mod. And I think you are aware about it. Mod z is equal to a means circle with radius a. Do you know this? No problem. Now I've told you, right? Remember this here onwards. So mod z is equal to a is circle with radius a. So in our given problem, only z is mentioned. So what does this mean? We always take mod. So mod z, right? And we'll equate it to 0. That means mod z is equal to a. Next, z plus 1. Z plus 1 means what? Z equal to minus 1, right? We'll equate it to 0. So z plus 1 equal to 0 means z is equal to minus 1. But we always take mod. So mod means we'll consider the positive value. So that will be mod z equal to 1. And the last one is z minus 2. So z minus 2, if you equate to 0, so z equal to 2. That means mod z is equal to 2. So in this way, we're going to get three circles from this. The first one is z equal to 0. That is mod z equal to 0. So mod z equal to 0 means circle with radius 0. Now I'm sure circle with radius 0 means what? Point. Obviously there is no radius. That means it's a plane point. So this is your mod z equal to 0. Next, z plus 1. And the third one is z minus 2. Friends, first of all, this plus sign, this minus sign doesn't matter. Why? Because anyhow, we are taking mod. So that doesn't matter actually to us, right? So z plus 1 equal to 0 means z is equal to minus 1, but we're taking mod. That means mod z is equal to 1. And as we discussed, mod z is equal to 1 is what? Circle with radius 1. So mod z is equal to 1 means circle with radius 1. And let's move on to the last part. Z minus 2, z minus 2 equal to 0, z equal to 2, mod z is equal to 2 means what? Circle with radius 2. Perfect. So let's draw this. Obviously, circle with radius 1 will be the smaller circle and circle with radius 2 will be the bigger one. So there is nothing to explain it. So let's move on and let us understand how you're going to actually identify the ROC. So ROC is the fixed technique. I'm telling you how to find ROC. A point, male eye here, male eye here, male eye here. That means a point male eye here means inside this particular circle. And obviously, if the point is inside this circle, so obviously it is inside this circle only. The second case is point is lying here. That means outside this circle and inside this circle. And the last is outside this bigger circle. So obviously, if it is outside bigger circle, so it has to be outside smaller circle. So in 99% of the problems, you will get three cases only. Point lying inside the smaller circle, this one. Point lying between both the circles. And the last one is point lying to the outer circle, right? So there will be three cases always. Not always, you can say 99% times. So let me actually write it down, these three cases that we have just discussed. So point is inside the smaller circle. So case number one is inside the smaller circle means mod z less than 1. See, inside means less and outside means greater. So the point is inside this circle, right? And this is z equal to 1. So z is equal to 1 and this is the point. That means it is less than 1. And for the second case, the point is lying between 1 and 2, right? So case number 2 is point is lying between 1 and 2. And case number 3 is what? See here, point is lying outside this greater circle. And lying outside means we're going to take the greater wala sign. So mod z greater than 2. So these are the three cases for this particular problem. Now I'm going to tell you how to solve or how to find Laurent'z and Taylor series expansion for all the three cases. We'll see one by one. So starting with the first case. Case number one, mod z is less than 1. So before going ahead, see, if you remember one note, your life will be very simple. So what is that? You just need to remember. Remember this, and this topic will be the simplest of your life. So the note is, inside constant, outside z. So you just need to remember this. Fix in your mind, that's it. So what exactly this means? I'm going to explain you right now. F of z is minus 1 upon 2z plus 1 upon 3 z plus 1 plus 1 upon 6 z minus 2. So this is the equation that we got from partial fraction. So let us start solving for case number 1. So I'm drawing my ROC here. Case number 1 means point lying inside the inner circle. That means point is somewhere here inside this inner circle. So do you remember the note? Inside constant, outside z. So for now, keep the first term as it is. I'll tell you the logic later on. As of now, keep the first term as it is. So we're keeping minus 1 upon 2z as it is, as of now. 1 upon 3. Now let us check the point is inside or outside. See, this is z plus 1. Z plus 1 means this particular circle, and obviously point is inside this. Second is z minus 2, that means this circle, again point is inside this circle also. In short, point is inside to both the circles, and since it is inside, do you remember? See, we're going to take constant common. We're going to take constant common. So we'll be taking constant common from these two terms. And what is the constant here? 1. So if you take 1 common, obviously the term will remain same, because taking 1 common is nothing actually. The term will remain same. So z plus 1 will remain same. Let's move on. Now tell me what is common here. since the point is inside this particular circle, therefore common is constant, and what is the constant? Constant is minus 2. So you need to take minus 2 common. Taking common means what? Dividing the terms. So minus 2 will be divided to both the terms. So the first term will become minus z by 2 plus 1. You are dividing by minus 2 to both the terms. Right, the next step is convert the problem into 1 plus or 1 minus format. What I am saying is, see, this is z plus 1, right? Write it down as 1 plus z. 1 plus or 1 minus, that means the beginning should be 1 plus or 1 minus. Just swap the terms, that's it, nothing else. Here it will be minus 1 upon 12, and what are you going to write it down here? 1 minus z by 2. Just swap the terms. That's it. In the next step, 1 plus z and 1 minus z by 2, you're going to take it up. So, which is equal to minus 1 upon 2z plus 1 upon 3, 1 plus z. If you take it up, that will become your inverse. Plus 1 upon minus 12. See, this is the minus 12. Basically, I'm taking this sign also. You can take here plus and here minus. So, no problem. 1 minus z by 2 inverse. So, before starting this, I've told you two formulas. If you remember, 1 minus x inverse. What is that? 1 plus x square plus x cube plus dot dot dot. And the second one was 1 plus x inverse. If you have plus and minus, then it will be alternate plus minus, right? So, based on these two formulas, this will become, see here in this equation, one is plus and one is minus. So, therefore, it will be alternate plus minus. So, 1 minus x. But in this formula, instead of x, we do have z. So, there will be 1 minus z plus z square minus z cube and so on dot 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 minus 1 upon 12. Since both are minus here, everything will be plus. So 1 plus x square plus x cube and so on. But in this problem, what is x? X is z by 2. So 1 plus z by 2 plus z by 2 the whole square plus dot dot dot. So this is done with the first case. So let us start solving the next one. So case number 2 is 1 less than mod z less than 2. If I draw ROC, that means I am talking about a point lying between these two circles. That means the point is somewhere around here, somewhere in between a smaller circle and the bigger circle. That means this shade. Right? So our given problem is f of z is equal to minus 1 upon 2z plus 1 upon 3z plus 1 plus 1 upon 6z minus 2. Right? So what is the technique? Inside constant, outside z. So let us identify where exactly the point is, outside of which circle and inside of which circle. So in the given problem, the point is here, that is outside this circle, outside the smaller circle. That means outside mod z is equal to 1, and the point is inside the bigger circle. That means mod z is equal to 2. So it's quite clear now. First term, don't touch it, keep it as it is. I'll tell you the reason in a few minutes. Plus, the point is outside this circle. We have just discussed this is your smaller circle and point is lying outside the circle. And for outside we take z common, right? Yes. So, we'll take z common from these two terms. So, z is here. Taking common means what? Dividing. So, 1 plus 1 by z plus 1 upon 6. Point is lying inside this circle. This is your bigger circle, right? And point is lying inside this circle. And whenever the point is inside the circle, we take what common? Constant. So, what is your constant here? Minus 2. So, you'll be left with minus z by 2 plus 1. What is the next step? Same repeated story. So what is the next step? Convert the problem into 1 plus or 1 minus format. So this term will remain as it is, 1 upon 3z. This term is already 1 plus, so no need to touch it, keep it as it is. This is minus 1 upon 12. You can write it down, this term, as 1 minus z by 2. So this is 1 plus 1 minus format. What is the next step? So f of z equal to minus 1 upon 2z plus 1 upon 3z. So 1 plus 1 by z will go up. So 1 plus 1 by z will go up and will become inverse. Minus 1 upon 12, 1 minus z by 2 will go up and will become inverse. And what is the last step? Yes, the same formula, 1 minus x inverse, 1 plus x square and so on. And 1 plus x inverse is 1 minus x plus x square and so on. So minus 1 upon 2z plus 1 upon 3z. Since it here it is plus or minus, so it will be alternate plus minus in the formula. So that will be 1 minus 1 upon z plus 1 upon z the whole square minus dot dot dot, because instead of x, 1 upon z is given in the problem. So x will be replaced by 1 upon z. Minus 1 upon 12. Since both are minus, everything will be plus. So 1 plus z by 2 plus z by 2 the whole square plus dot dot dot. That's it. So we're done with the second case. Now we are left with the last case, and the procedure will remain same. Inside constant, outside z. Story will remain same. So let's quickly solve case number 3. Case number 3, mod z greater than 2 means, let me drawing ROC. The point is outside both the circles. Outside both the circle means it is outside greater circle and smaller circle both. So let me write down the question again. 1 upon 3 z plus 1 plus 1 upon 6 z minus 2. Now it is quite clear. This is your z is equal to 1 circle. This is your z is equal to 2 circle. Point is lying outside to both the circle. That means we're going to take z common from both the terms. So again, the first term will remain as it is. In the second term, you're going to take z common, 3z, 1 plus 1 upon z plus 1 upon 6 z. If you take z common, this will become 1 minus 2 by z. So what is the next step? 1 plus and 1 minus format. So luckily, thank God, it's already 1 plus and 1 minus format. So this step is avoided. So what is the next step? Yes. So this is 1 2z plus 1 upon 3z, 1 plus 1 upon z inverse plus 1 upon 6z, 1 minus 2 by z inverse. So we need to expand it, and that's it. So f of z equal to minus 1 upon 2z plus 1 upon 3z. Now here we have plus and minus. So 1 minus 1 upon z plus 1 upon z the whole square minus dot 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 alternate plus minus. And in the last one we have both minus, so everything will be plus. So plus 1 upon 6z, 1 plus 2 by z plus 2 by z the whole square plus dot dot dot. Now friends, so this is done with the third case also. Now I'll tell you the logic why we kept this first term as it is. So our logic in this problem is to take common. So either going to take constant common or going to take z common. And friends, this is the basic concept. For taking common, there should be at least two terms, right? So see here, you can take any case basically. So let me take this here. This is the first term. This is the second term, and you can consider any case. This is valid for entire question. So there are two terms here. So we took common. What common? That is a different story, whether it is constant or z, but at least we took common, right? This is your single term, and you cannot take common from one term, right? So therefore we are keeping the first term same. So this is not a logic, huh? You will always not keep the first term as it is. This is not the case. But in this problem, since this first term is only one term and we can't take common from the first term, therefore we are keeping it as it is. So I think this video is a bit longer, but friends, if you understood this problem clearly, there is no variation in this particular chapter. Rest all the problems will remain same. So you will save a lot of time in the next videos. So friends, if you understood this problem, the later part of the video, so later questions will be very simple to you, because so this is the main concept of the problem, and in the next videos we'll see how to solve the further problems. Thank you.